Today we're going to show you how to make a private virtual machine, or VM, accessible through a public load balancer in Google Cloud. Imagine you have a private VM without any external IP addresses or special setups like CloudNet. We'll transform this simple VM into the backend for a web application working behind a load balancer. Let's start by understanding the concept. You begin with a private VM system or application. We won't cover creating a web application on Google Cloud today, but keep in mind that this VM will soon play an important role. Our main goal is to put a load balancer in front of the VM. This load balancer will be publicly accessible and act as a security layer. This setup is useful for several reasons. First, it allows you to centralize controls like web application firewall policies for your VMs. It gives you detailed network and security controls without directly exposing your VMs to the internet. Second, it helps with scaling. For example, if your web application servers are in one region, like US Central, using a global load balancer in front will make your application easier to access from anywhere in the world. Now let's walk through the steps to set this up. First, create an instance group for your web application. To keep things simple, we'll use an unmanaged instance group with just one VM. This group will include our existing VM in the US Central 1C zone. Next, add the VM to the instance group manually. We'll also set up port mapping for the HTTP port that our web application will use. Then set up an HTTP load balancer. This will be public-facing and global, which means it can serve your application from many points around the world. We'll use the HTTP protocol and connect it to our web application backend. For now, we'll leave the Cloud CDN option unchecked to keep things simple. Finally, create a health check for the load balancer. This is important because our VM is private and doesn't have a public IP address. We'll need to allow the health check to access our VM. For the health check, we'll keep it simple, use a TCP check on port 80, and keep all other settings at their defaults. After setting up the load balancer, we'll need to wait a few minutes for it to be ready. While we wait, we'll see that there's an issue with the health checks. Our firewall rules aren't set up to allow these checks yet, so we'll need to fix that. First, we need to find the IP ranges used by the health check probes. We can find this information in the Google Cloud documentation. For a global external application load balancer, the traffic comes from two specific IP ranges. Next, we'll create a new firewall rule in our VPC network. It's important to note that we're using a custom demonstration network, not the default network that usually comes with new projects. Our current network only allows SSH access through an identity-aware proxy. Let's create a new firewall rule called Allow Health Probes. Apply it to our demonstration network. Instead of allowing all instances, we'll use a more specific approach with target tags. We'll create a tag called Private HTTP Server and use this to identify which VMs should allow health check access. Add both of the IP ranges that we found in the documentation as the source IPs. Allow TCP traffic on port 80, which is the standard port for HTTP. After creating the firewall rule, we need to add the HTTP server tag to our VM. Fortunately, we can do this without restarting the VM. We just need to edit the VM settings and add the tag. This setup creates a clear path for access. Users and potential bad actors can only access our application through the load balancer, where we have many security controls. They can't directly access the VM because it doesn't have a public IP address. The health check probes can reach the VM, but only from specific IP ranges and only to the HTTP port. Now comes the exciting part, testing our setup. Let's go back to our load balancer and check its status. If everything is working correctly, we should see a green check mark indicating that our backend is healthy. This means our backend is now accessible. To fully test our setup, we'll try accessing the load balancer's IP address. If successful, we should see our backend application's content. As usual, we'll provide the tutorial diagram in the video description for your reuse. If you'd like to support the channel, check out our new design tool via the free trial link in the description and let us know what you think. Many thanks for watching until the end, and please enjoy responsibly.